What's going on, everybody? Shri Kanase here. So what should you start avoiding in 2019, specifically 2020 and onwards, when it comes to Shopify dropshipping? As the year comes to an end when I'm recording this video, which is in mid-October of 2019, it's an absolute fact that all of us who are using Shopify or just doing e-com in general can't accept that the e-commerce world has changed significantly since the past few months and specifically the past year. Now, personally, when I started doing Shopify dropshipping, which is in 2017, it was much easier to get results and find success. But it's no lie that it has become much, much more harder to find such results now, specifically come 2020, just because there are so many people trying to do the same exact thing just like you. And because of this, it becomes really important to know exactly what you should be avoiding specifically when dropshipping or running a Shopify store so that you can stand out of the crowd and still continue to crush it come 2020 and onwards. But by the end of this video, you're gonna know the top 5 things that you should be doing differently from what you were previously doing, or if you haven't even done those yet, you'll know exactly what not to do. But without wasting any more time, let's just jump right into it. So things to avoid. The first one that I would like to start talking about is trust badges. Now, I know before 2020 and specifically even in the later parts of 2019, everybody was all about trust badges. Literally every Shopify guru would talk about having trust badges all over your website. It'll just have one right below the add to cart button, maybe one below the description, and have all of these fake things. And now what I've come to realize specifically for 2020 and onwards is there is no such thing as forced trustworthiness when it comes to using these trust badges. Think about it. The main reason why we use these trust badges in the first place is so that people can trust our website. But in 2020 and onwards, those trust badges are not necessary at all, because you can't really force people to trust you by just looking at a trust badge. And these have become so common even amongst those websites that scam people that the general population has stopped believing in such things as trust badges. So it is actually something that I recommend that you do not put on your website come 2020 and onwards. And the main thinking behind this is the trust has to happen naturally, and that can only happen based on what kind of layout your website has, whether it is professional and simple or whether it is super unprofessional and too complicated for the user to use. In addition to that, one of the biggest factors to trustworthiness is the color scheme. One question you want to ask yourself is the color scheme on your website matching overall or not? Meaning, is there some black used at the very top and then the color red used in the middle and then the color green used at the very end? If that's the case, then that is really unprofessional and the color scheme is all over the place. So one thing I recommend is you want to have one color scheme and stick to it. And I'll be showing you example websites very soon as to what you should be doing. But the third and final thing is how much work your website is making the person do. Again, trustworthiness comes from the interaction people have with your website. Think of it as an interaction with a person that you meet. If somebody that you just met makes you do tons of favors and asks you to do one thing after the other, you're kind of gonna get irritated. And that's the same thing when it comes to interactions with websites. People get irritated if you ask them to do too many things, and they kind of just lose trust in the relationship they have kind of been building with your website. So to keep the trust going, you wanna make sure that the person does as less work as possible, because then the person starts to think that you have their intentions in mind, not yours. And they start trusting you much, much more. So one example website that I actually wanna show you right away is mvmtwatches.com. Now, I know this is not a dropshipping store, but in the beginning, it actually started as a dropshipping store and it has sold for a really huge amount. I think it's millions of dollars. So nowadays, one thing I'm also recommending that I've listed in the specific Google Doc is try to mimic other brand websites. Don't mimic dropshipping stores anymore. And MVMT Watch is one of the best websites that you can mimic. But if we go on their specific product page, we can see that the overall layout is very, very simple yet professional. There is nothing extra added to their website. As you can see, there are no trust badges right below that to cart button. There's no unnecessary timers over here, which I'm going to be talking about very soon. And everything is just very simple and straightforward. It makes the person, whoever is browsing, very easy to navigate and makes his or her life very easy. So this is what people are expecting nowadays. And as you can see, if we even look at the mobile device view, we can see that the website and the product page specifically still very simple and very clean, just some black and some green in the bottom. But overall, the theme is the same. There's no difference in theme color. But this is exactly what you should be doing yourself when it comes to trust badges. Now, moving on to number 2, and that is cart timers. Now, this is a different kind of timer. This is not a timer that you have on your product page. Rather, this is something that you have on the cart page. I was recommending cart timers a lot specifically in my previous videos, and I even use an app for this specific cart timer. But nowadays, I've completely stopped using cart timers. And the main reason behind this is there is no need to show any kind of fake scarcity in order to persuade the person to act right now. Now, the main reason as to why we were even using timers in the first place is to persuade people to act right now. But what I've started to realize is there is no need to do this kind of fake scarcity to persuade them to buy right now. And the main reason behind that is if you have the right product targeted to the right audience with the right website layout, which I mentioned earlier in the first section, then they're gonna purchase no matter what. Whether you have a timer or not really makes no difference in their thinking, because if they want the product, they're gonna buy it. They're gonna find reasons themselves to buy that product even if you don't provide them reasons. So that's the main thing as to why you should not be using cart timers. Now it just ruins all of the professionalism in my own experience. And if we go back to MVMT watches and add this specific product to cart, we can see that there is no kind of timers involved in this case. It's just a cart drawer over here, and it opens up to the checkout section, which when we click, it just takes us directly to the checkout. Nothing too fancy, no kinds of timers, none of that stuff. And again, this is really good because it makes everything very simple, professional, and sleek, which is what customers expect. But if we go back now, moving on to the third thing, and this actually is importing unedited reviews for your products. Now, what do I mean by this exactly? When you import reviews to your store for a product, all you do is you simply insert the link from AliExpress or from Amazon into the Shopify review app, whatever you're using, and just import them directly and then forget about the reviews. If you're doing that, that is a really horrible way to import reviews, and that could lead to a lot of lost sales and a lot of untrustworthiness from the customer side. Instead of just importing reviews and forgetting about them, what you should rather be doing is you should be importing reviews than finding the product on Amazon or eBay or wherever, and then copying and pasting the reviews on Amazon or eBay or any other website onto your Shopify store via the app. And the main reason behind this is most AliExpress reviews, first of all, they have bad English because they're translated from other languages. Second, some of them are one word reviews like awesome, cool, good AliExpress supplier. These kinds of words, they're not helping potential customers in any way. They're not telling anything about the product. And what happens is people kind of just lose interest if they see these kind of reviews nowadays in 2020 and onwards. So in order to battle this, again, import the reviews directly from Amazon. And by this, what I mean is still use AliExpress to import the reviews, but manually go in and edit each review and copy and paste those from Amazon or eBay or wherever you can find the reviews for that same product. Because what I've noticed is using Amazon or eBay to find these reviews to add to your store makes the whole experience much better. Because those reviews really talk a lot about the product. Some of the people take time to talk about the pros as well as the cons, as well as some tips and tricks, which if a potential customer on your website reads, they're much more inclined to kind of buy from you. So it's kind of an advantage for you if you do this part. But definitely make sure to avoid unedited imported reviews and rather import reviews from AliExpress, but then use Amazon or eBay to your advantage. Now, moving on to our fourth thing, and that is payments in installments. Now, before I talk about this, I want to go back to MVMT watches and show you exactly what I mean. So if we go on MVMT watches product page for any specific product, so let's do just that. Let's go on to this specific product page. And if we go on there, one thing we're going to see is that MVMT lets you pay in installments. Right below the specific price of the product, as you can see, it says pay in 4 installments of $33.75, no fees. Klarna. So Klarna is actually a service which offers the installment pay. Another service that offers these installment payments is Afterpay. And I actually highly recommend that you start using them in 2020 and onwards, because that is a really simple yet awesome way to stand out of the crowd. I mean, think about it. How many dropshippers are currently offering them? If you start offering that payment method, you're immediately going to stand out of the crowd amongst all of those other dropshipping stores. And it's just going to be something different on your website. People are going to have a different experience when it comes to payments on your website. And overall, they're not going to compare you to those scamming dropshipping websites or just dropshipping websites in general, because again, you did something different. And the main reason as to why I recommend that you start using payments in installments is because it increases the overall trust of your website. If people love to pay in installments rather than paying a whole sum of money And if you're doing high ticket products, this is really a good thing that you should 100% have on your store. Another thing why people like this is because it offers some extra time for people to pay back the product. It's just like using a credit card. Instead of paying $1,000 one time, wouldn't you want to pay $200 five times? That just kind of makes you psychologically feel like you're not spending too much money, and it kind of makes you want to actually purchase that just because you're not paying the whole $1,000 in a single pay. And again, that's just a psychological factor which kind of helps people in making their decisions. Again, high ticket products definitely need this, but even if you're low ticket, maybe $20, $30, $40, even $50, you should definitely have this just to stand out of the crowd. But moving on to our final thing, and that is about free shipping. So one thing I highly recommend that you stop doing is offering free shipping to everybody. I know free shipping has become a trend now just because big stores like Amazon, Target, Walmart, etc. offer free shipping, but this is something which I personally use strategically, and I recommend you do the same. Instead of offering free shipping to everybody and making it lose its value, why not offer free shipping over a certain percent order value? So what I do on my own store is I do something like free shipping on orders over $55. You can do something like free shipping on orders over $50 or whatever you want to do. That's up to you. But basically, do not offer free shipping on everything, because people start to associate free shipping as something that's just kind of given to them without any extra effort. When people actually have to work towards that free shipping, psychologically, they're much more likely to be satisfied, considering that you do give them a good quality product, but it also kind of makes your website stand out of the crowd. Every single dropshipper currently offers free shipping, so why not do something different and charge shipping? Now, this is something I recommend because I do this myself. I do not offer free shipping, as I mentioned, and in fact, my conversion rates have stayed the same and actually improved. Not only have my conversion rates improved, my overall average order value has improved because of this. I'm getting higher average order values, and my profits have increased because of this. So this is something that is 100% what I recommend for your Shopify store as well. Again, the amount of order value that you should have for the free shipping amount depends on your store. If your bestseller is only $20, then I recommend that you put this value at $25. Basically, whatever your average order value is, currently just add $5 to this, and that should give you the correct amount as to what you should be offering free shipping for. But these are the top five things that you should definitely avoid at all costs when it comes to drop shipping in 2020 and onwards. Again, don't use trust badges, avoid cart timers, don't import reviews and then forget about them, do something different about them. And the fourth thing is payments in installments. Offer payments in installments and people will be much more likely to trust you. And finally, don't offer free shipping, be strategic about it and give them free shipping over a certain order value. But if you found any type of value in this video, make sure to smash that like button down below and subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys next time.